Yo, what is going on YouTube? It's your boy Dan, aka A-Drop. But guys, a brand new video today. Today we are jumping into the rumor mill for Pokemon Sword and Shield in the Isle of Armor DLC. This massive rumor has been posted to 4chan, and as always, I gotta give you the disclaimer that we take these things with a pinch of salt, because you never know if it's gonna be real or not. But for those who joined me before Sword and Shield came out, we had a blast talking about rumors. And of course, we had the infamous Ben Affleck leak, which leaked so much about the game prior to it coming out. So this may be some of our first looks into the Isle of Armor DLC, which we are waiting for a release date eagerly. It could come at any moment, but be sure to like the video and subscribe if you guys are new. Turn those notifications on. You do not want to miss a single one of these videos and just the amazing content we've been putting out on the channel lately. And I want to put a big shout out to my friend Ruffled Rowlet, who passed this along to me. He also covered this on his channel, and I'll put his link in the description as well. But this rumor covers a lot of different things, including new Gigantamax forms, new Pokemon, new Galarian forms, storyline plots, and the new moves, the 21 moves that were leaked. So lots of good stuff. Let's jump into it, baby. All right, so let's get started on kind of the left-hand side here. It's indicating that there's going to be a trailer on 6/19 with a release of 6/26. I know a lot of people are waiting to hear about the release date. We still don't have it. I'm still thinking it's going to be the second part of June, but again, there's not really a lot of clarity there. I don't think it got pushed back. There is a fake tweet going around of a Pokemon Direct, but that was from 2019 as an FYI for those who see it. Talk a little about the Curry decks getting expanded with some new items, the Zetsy Citrus, the Wild Rice, Blossom Honey, Robust Chilies, Fish Flakes. And then Calyrex was created a bird trio as protectors for the Megan tree, not the same as the Kanto trio. So it remains to be seen, is this the Zapdos, Articuno, Moltres that we saw? Are they a completely different trio? Are they named differently, or are they actually named the same? I mean, one would think they'd be named the same, but there is this Megan tree, which we're going to talk about here. Telequatro, new Pokemon, Psychic-type, Sinnoh-Synco? I think I understand this. 4, 5, 6. Those are the names of the birds, I guess, right? Telequatro, Sinnoh-Synco, and Assail-Sais. So Quatro, Cinco, Sais. It's Spanish, just like Articuno, Zapdos, Moltres. Oh my god, I sound like an idiot. Anyway, we got the Megan tree, which is poisonous. Fruits produce every 3,000 years, which can grant immortality. AZ, I'm looking at you and your Floette. Tarragon aimed at obtaining the fruit. I don't know who Tarragon is. I don't think we know who that is yet. Rose event in each DLC, so apparently Chairman Rose is gonna make an appearance again, despite his kind of craziness at the end of Sword and Shield. Spoilers. Isle of Armor, Volkner gives player Shinx. Oh baby, for those who don't know, Volkner is an electric type gym leader in the Sinnoh region, focusing on electric type Pokemon. Volkner gives the player Blossom Honey for Curry, and then he also speaks about how different Pokemon in Sinnoh are. Ooh, Sinnoh hints, baby. We got the Crown Tundra Ambassador NPC Balsam from the neighboring region has a new form of Zangoose and Seviper. So this could be a teaser to the Crown Tundra, which would actually make quite a bit of sense if they did that. There's a gift of Zangoose, Seviper, different typings though, fighting in dark. And then the Ambassador speaks to a long trading history with Galar. Mentions that he wants to see a Calpurajah while in Galar as they are different. Gives the player robust chilies for Curry. And then the Regis myth gets expanded through rune stove carvings like the ones found in Turffield. There's Regivolt, which is electric type, and Regivern, which is dragon type. So we have seen new Regis, and one of them looks like the big dragon head that's sitting outside of Hammerlock, I believe it is. So pretty cool there. Player can capture both, although it's at different points of the game. Remains to be seen whether this is tied into the Ground Tundra or not. Galarian Slowpoke, kind of our main teaser for the Isle of Armor. Its evolutions are introduced, and there's going to be Galarian Slowbro, which is psychic and ghost, has a corseless shell on each of its arms, which ties into the new move that we heard of, which we'll get to at the tail end of this video. Galarian Slowking, which is apparently psychic poison that has a Marini crown. So it's got the corseless shell, the ghost corseless shell on its arms, and then Slowking has the Marini crown, apparently. Galarian Fanpyline with a new regional evolution. The dex entry explains that it results from cohabitating with Calpurajah. You got the Galarian Fanpy, which is fighting type, and then it evolves into Rufiant, which is fighting and steel, which kind of makes a lot of sense, right? We've seen some of these evolutions, Yamask and then Runerigus instead of Cofagrigus. Galarian Tentacool line based on a ghost jellyfish. It's an ice type, and then it becomes ice and ghost Tentagool. Oh my god, is that like a real thing? Please tell me this is real. Tentagool? Oh my god, I need it in my life. Galarian Mankey, based on the Japanese macaws. You got Galarian Mankey, which is fighting an ice type, and then you have Primal Lanch. Oh, these are so good. Galarian Snubbull based on pit bulls. It's a quadruped, and it's ground type, and then Galarian Granbull also ground type, and then Eternatus Eternamax form is released. Now let's dive into some of these other little rumors here on this page. There's some great stuff here. New Gigantamax forms released in July and August, aside from Urshifu, Kanto, and Galar starters. We know that Venusaur, Blastoise getting Gigantamax forms. We know that we got the Galarian starters with their very disappointing abilities that ignore abilities, and then we'll have to see what happens there. Rotom's gonna resemble a Tesla coil, so these are gonna be Gigantamax forms. Rotom getting a G-Max, which would actually be really cool to buff regular Rotom as opposed to its various forms, but maybe all of them get it. Luxray gets a Manticore theme, which is very interesting. Grapplelock gets a Bunching Bag motif, which I do think Grapplelock needs some loves. And Stonejourner gets a stacked Stonehenge look. Talonflame gets a Scrambler Jet theme. Polisand gets a Taj Mahal motif. Pukumuku and Pincurchin share a Gigantamax form. That's probably the most unbelievable thing in this video so far, is that Pukumuku and Pincurchin share a Gigantamax form. But I mean, Appleton and Flapple do, so I guess I can't be, you know, that surprised. There's a treasure map side quest, and you get a new Pokemon called Crabloon, which sounds so good, like doubloon and crab. I love it. Zarude will be a mystery gift after completing the Tower of Two Fists story, and then the next mythical is Shakespeare-themed Quervosio. Digging Duo Sisters can be found in the DLCs instead of the Duo Bros. They dig up certain fossils from previous generations. That sounds amazing. And all Generation 1 obtainable through regional forms can trade over from home. Further, 217 out of the Crossbow DLCs. The Legendary Beast will freely open or roam the open world. A callback to the Generations 2 appearance. Eucene will make a minor appearance as he has tracked the beast to Galar. And Kurt's granddaughter, Maisie, and her Galarian Slowpoke may be visited for Apricorn Balls. Now, we know that we're going to get new Apricorn Balls, or at least they're going to come back. And it makes so much sense that Kurt's granddaughter would be the one there, because she's the one that we see in HeartGold SoulSilver, the little girl in the house. And of course, Kurt has his history with Slowpokes. It makes so much sense, team. It really does. And let's look at these moves as the last thing for this video here before we kind of summarize, man. Oh my god, so much good stuff, dude. These are some of the new moves. And we know that these moves are confirmed, by the way. I don't know if these types are real or whatever, but these moves did leak through Pokemon Home. I have another video covering that. You guys can check that out. But basically, expanding forces of fighting type, special based, earthquake equivalent. Steel Roller is a rollout equivalent. Scale Shot is a dragon type, special based. Meteor Beam is a psychic type, steel beam equivalent. Wow, that actually could be really good. There's some really, I mean, Psycho Boost is kind of like that, but I guess this takes the damage. Shell Sidearm is Galarian Slowbro's signature move. It reduces speed. Interesting. I wonder what it reduces speed of, because Slowbro is theoretically really slow. Misty Explosion is a fairy type, steel beam equivalent. Grassy Glide is a grass type, flying press equivalent. Zarude's signature move. Interesting. Rising Voltage is an electric type, flying type, press equivalent. Terrain Pulse is a weather ball equivalent based on the terrain, which is something that people have kind of speculated. We've got Skitter Smack, which is a fighting type, Kubfu's signature move. Burning Jealousy is a fire type, steel beam equivalent. So a lot of these similar ideas. Lash Out is a dark type, revenge equivalent. Poltergeist is a ghost type, buffed Sash Shock equivalent. Galarian Slowking signature move. Okay, that's interesting. So Slowking gets a signature move, which is Poltergeist. Has to do, of course. Although I'm a little confused. This is a little strange to me. Because the Slowking is the one that has the Marini on its head, and Slowbro is the one that have the Corsals on its head. So I guess why would Slowking get a ghost type move? I'm not sure. Just something to note there that I just thought of. Corrosive Gas, which is like a buffed acid spray, which, okay, we already have acid spray, so I don't know why they would make a buffed version of it, but it could be really good in limited distribution. Coaching is a normal type, transfer stat boost to selected ally. That's an amazing idea, actually. Flip Turn is apparently fairy type. There's a lot of reasons to believe it's water type, though, so I will point that out. Triple Axel is a steel type move, which is triple hit. Dual Wing Beat is a flying type move that hits twice. Scorching Sands is a ground type move that's a scald equivalent, so it's a ground type move that can burn. That would be incredible, by the way. Wicked Blow is dark type Urshifu's single signature move, and Surging Strikes is Urshifu's signature move as well for the water type one. So as you guys can see, I mean, just some incredible stuff here in this rumor. Let me kind of get it to size here. Some incredible stuff in this rumor. Am I right or am I right? Now, we do see some things that are a little questionable, especially towards the end there with some of those moves. But again, all we know are the names of the moves. We don't really know what the situation is. And it is possible that a Pokemon can have a signature move that doesn't really align with their primary typing. I'm not saying that's impossible, but some interesting stuff here, man. I will say this is probably one of the more believable rumors we've come across I don't know if it's accurate or not. I don't know if it's legit. Time will tell. I'm still expecting there to be some sort of a trailer or information to roll out any day now, but this is telling us that it's going to be a few more weeks. But regardless, stay tuned, guys. There is going to be a DLC trailer before it comes out. I mean, inevitably, and we're going to get some new information there. So, as I had said, guys, be sure to like the video. Subscribe if you guys are new. Do not forget to turn them notifications on. You do not want to miss these videos, guys. I've got some amazing content planned for you guys over the next few weeks leading into the DLC and then beyond. We're going to have an amazing summer, guys. It's going to be incredible. So thank you guys for watching. Let me know your thoughts in the comments section below about the rumors. And let me know if you guys are excited that the rumor videos are back. That's going to be it for me, guys. My name is Dan. I also go by A-Drive, and I will see you guys on the next one. Peace.